Let me take you to a place now located in the sky. Beautiful little theater where nerds multiply. Anything is possible. Grow wings and fly. And slay dragons with the magic of the third eye. Whether you come from the past or arrive from the future. As a medieval knight or galactic star trooper. It's all possible when you in that other world. Where you could be yourself, whether boy or a girl. So many different events to attend, my friend. And if you got a funny bone, there's improv for the win. You can catch me in the alchemist lab, sipping sonic screwdrivers, adding clout to my tab. Since 2012, this other world been in rotation. When it comes to the arts, man, it's like a vocation.
What do you want from us, Portal-Prov? a fate as bad as mine. Oh, you better, and you better be perfect. You better nail every nuance of the Willy Wonka universe, or else. You must find out all you can about the Willy Wonkaverse. Quickly, quickly, I'll do my best. Now go, discover.
Just explain to me what the Willy Wonka, what happened?
Willy Wonka, a mysterious billionaire, he takes five children randomly selected into a tour of his chocolate factory. It's full of whimsy, but also traps that lead to the children's demise slash maiming.
I like how still he is.
Out, clear out some of the rat traps, you're gonna have a wonderful location for a factory.
Right here in the middle of the city?
Yeah, right here in Manhattan, heart of Manhattan. The last people who owned it were a bit eccentric.
Okay.
So there is sort of a channel cut into the eastern side for a river. But I mean, that could work in your interest if you have like a sluice of automobile oil or like lithium waste. Yeah.
What is that giant tube that sucks bubbles going up? Was that gonna help us?
Yeah. So the last guy who owned this, a bit eccentric. But kept the tube in great repair. Okay, that's a tube that sucks things up. It is got a PSI strength of at least 3 American children.
Freeze! Freeze! The portals, they ebb and flow unexpectedly. And just as we find ourselves in the Willy Wonka universe, we find ourselves jumping genres at any given moment. So can I get another genre that this scene might take place in?
Film noir.
Film noir!
It was 1972, I was in the heart of Manhattan. I realized I ran out of cigarettes in my left pocket, so I reached into my right pocket and grabbed my second pack of cigarettes to smoke. I was very interested to see where this tube went, and I was aiming to find out.
I was there too, but in the background with little dialogue.
Now listen up, you crumb bombs. If you want to... beautiful factory here, I got it. You can buy it. But if you're not gonna buy, then I'm gonna ask you to hooscow.
Freeze! New genre!
Horror!
Horror! Spooky horror!
Oh my god, look, what, there's a kid that got turned into a blueberry! Holy hell!
I don't see anything. Darling, you're freaking out.
That kid's my friend.
What kid?
What? He sees me every night.
There's no blueberry, it's just an empty shaft.
He sees me every night and says, squish, squish, squish into jail. Squish, squish, squish into jail.
Look, you all, there is simply nothing to fear. Okay, this
don't
is
stay too close to it.
What? Close to what? I don't see a goddamn thing.
He'll squish you into jail. He'll squish you into jail.
Squish me into jam.
He'll squish you into jam.
Yeah, she said it a lot. Squish you into jam.
Squish me.
Oh my!
Golly gee, it's exhausting being plucky young kids in the city.
For real.
I wish there was something we could do to make our days seem more important, more special.
I'm hungover, it's the city. I can't believe I threw up all this perfectly good candy.
Oh, ew.
The magic of the city.
Disgusting and poor.
I don't know. Maybe if we follow that eccentric man with the big hair who wanders around all the time, we'd find a real nice place.
Okay, I only hang out with you because you're pretty.
Okay.
You need to stop talking like that all the time.
It's the way I talk. I'm trapped in this.
Okay, great eyebrows. Great. I think that we can just do whatever we want. We don't have to follow men anywhere.
What if they have gold?
Oh, then we should follow
them.
Yes, then we should follow them.
There's monetary value.
Where did he go?
I think in the big scary building with a little bit of purple smoke coming out.
Okay, cut two. We're there.
Woo-hoo, woo-hoo.
Whoa.
What's up, lady?
Are you who they call?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm Wonka.
Wow.
Put your stuff wherever, make yourself at home.
Wow, well, I don't have any stuff.
Yeah, literally.
We came for gold.
Yeah.
You came for gold.
All we want is gold.
Okay, yeah.
Maybe in ticket form.
Maybe in ticket form. Well, listen, lady.
Freeze! The portals ever flow and ebb. These characters are being rearranged. Players, switch characters!
I hate boys.
Oh, I'll bet you wouldn't say that if you knew me better.
You better be nice to that boy, man.
Unless you give me gold, I don't respect you.
You'll respect me, or you want me.
I respect you, and I want you, and I want the gold.
Whoa, too much. Too excited. Good for you, though.
You're so charming and handsome.
I know, it's exhausting being so complicated.
Switch characters!
Wow, mister. I love you.
You would love all this, wouldn't you?
Are you going to let us into your home or just stand out here and watch you wiggle a little bit?
Wait, that's my voice! Hang on a second. It's bleeding onto you.
You used to be a bitch. Now you're like cool and stuff.
See, I told you it was a cool voice. Asshole.
Maybe she's making me feel things.
You're making me feel things.
Whoa, are we all feeling things? Shouldn't we all jump into that big chocolate river together?
What could go wrong?
Probably nothing. Let's do it.
Hey, where does that big tube go? I'm still trying to figure out where that big freaking tube goes.
To the sky.
Dan. You're so hot.
Yeah.
Hey, you look a lot like that guy from Doom.
Work to feed you and your grandparents. Wait, are you my grandpa or grandma? I forget. You all look like puppets to me at this point.
Grandpa Joe, baby.
Grandpa Joe, I'm so sorry. My favorite, one of my four favorite grandparents. Hello, grandma.
I need a glass of water.
No problem, I'll just go to the well. That's just...
Cheer up!
Oh, your bony hands are so cold.
Cheer up, Charlie. Be happier.
Charlie, if you don't make any money soon, we'll all die.
Oh. Put on a happy face. I'll be right back with your water.
I'll stand you up a nice shirt. Nice clean shirt for you, Charlie.
Thanks, Mom. I'll take care of your parents. Boy, oh boy.
Charlie,
yes.
Put on a smile.
It's sudsy, which is good for cleaning out all the diseases inside your old belly.
Oh, Charlie, I spilled the water. Charlie, I spilled my whole sudsy water, Charlie.
That's no problem. Grandma, it's no problem.
Sweetheart, if you don't give me another...
Ow!
Sorry, my...
I have very poor bones.
Sorry.
The lack of calcium.
My bones are sticking out of my hands.
Yeah.
If you don't give me another such a glass of water, Charlie, we'll all die, Charlie.
No, don't die. I'll get you more. I have the bucket here.
Charlie, I'm gonna do it.
Yes. Charlie, you work too hard, Charlie.
I'm smiling. I don't work too hard.
Charlie, more soap, Charlie.
Yes,
I need some soap for the floor.
I'll shave it off of the...
Charlie, why don't you ever do anything fun for yourself?
Well, why not have fun for myself? This is fun. Taking care of my family is fun. I love everything.
Charlie, I'm bored. Could you do a silly dance?
Yes, Grandma. Yes. Here we go.
Charlie!
Now entering the king of the Oompa Loompas, Dave!
Simmer down now. Simmer down. Simmer down. Simmer down. There's a lot going on around here, and there's a mysterious case of five children just loose in our troops. No one's concerned about this yet.
I'm concerned. Do they have good behavior?
Not even a little bit. Only one of them does.
Well, then they deserve to die.
Yeah!
Now that's a good idea. You seem excited. How are we going to kill them in a chocolately ethical way?
I think we should fill them with raspberries.
Cass.
What?
Any other ideas?
Murder them with squirrels, or maybe a goose? Well,
we'll put it on the back burner. We'll put it on the back burner.
I think we should fill their pockets with a bunch of heavy raspberries.
I'm starting to warm up to the idea, I gotta be honest. It's kind of juicy.
Dave rocks. Dave, what if we filled their shoes with, like, super heavy, like, we put a bunch of raspberries in cement, and then we tied their shoes to the cement raspberries, and we pushed them into the chocolate river?
Not devious enough.
Okay, what if we hold them hostage and get ransom money?
I think we can do that. I think we can handle that.
Because we would just shoot them up that tube, and honest to God, nobody seems to know where it goes.
Why don't we just shoot them all up the tube?
All up the tube.
Everyone goes up the tube.
All up the tube.
Okay. Up the tube.
Oh. But then, please, can we sing? My favorite part of that is when we get to sing.
It sounds like Grace wants to sing. Grace wants to sing a song.
But can I?
The screaming kid. Now, Grace, an arousing rendition of Up the Tube, the screaming kid.
Look, there's that screaming little bastard now.
He's coming, he's coming.
Oh, no! Why are you doing this to me?
Take their vocal cords out, don't you? Beat them and beat them and cut a little bit. Make sure they have thin enough their speak. Beat them, make sure they don't talk. Take out their vocal cords. Oompa Loompa, I hate kids who they all scream. Oompa Loompa, doopa dee doo. Make sure they never scream, don't you?
I got great news. I found a golden ticket at a gas station. We got a free ticket to go check out a big friggin' factory. It's right in the center of town, right in the center of Manhattan for some reason.
Oh, Charlie, I used to work in a factory. It's not that special.
Grandpa, you're always talking about the Ford Motor Company. I'm sorry they didn't give you a good pension.
Yeah, they shit-canned me. 1 year away from my sweet retirement.
Yeah, I know, but I think maybe you could have deserved it, but that's neither here nor there.
Excuse me?
Yeah,
What did you say to me, young man?
Well, you used to drink so much at the factory, Grandpa. Maybe the...
Why do you think I drank so much?
Because
I busted my goddamn ass!
Oh,
every single day to put food on the table for your mother, who, and your deadbeat father, who walked out on us, couldn't handle the responsibility of taking care of a kid like you!
He was drafted.
Yeah!
He had to go!
You don't have to go to war, you idiot! You can be a conscientious objector like I was in Korea!
Grandpa, I'm beginning to think you're not such a good guy after all!
Oh, what do you know of good and evil? You child with your Nintendo Switch, where all you do is kill pig men all day long. You think that's training you to be a saint?
They're not really dead. When the blood moon happens, they come right back.
I don't even know what you're talking about. There's no blood on the moon, Neil Armstrong. Proved it. But you don't care about history.
Neil Armstrong never even landed on the moon, I bet. I bet it was all fake for money.
You shut your mouth.
Your favorite president's Ronald Reagan.
Damn right, he made a lot of good changes. He kept the Russians off our doorstep with a Star Wars program.
You think George W. Bush had a great reaction to 9/11?
What was his reaction like?
You was a bad kid. Get in the tube.
I'm not a bad kid. Someday I'm going to work in a factory that builds cars.
It's freaking cold in this part of the factory. It's so freaking cold over here in this part of the factory.
I'm feeling significantly less plucky.
Yeah, it sucks. Us three kids, I can't find that rapscallion Willy anywhere.
This is a message from Willy Wonka.
Where's that coming from?
It's coming from all the candy speakers.
Oh.
The temperature will drop 1 degree every minute. Until one of you can find a way out of this death room.
Oh my God! No! I'm sorry, did he just say a death room?
No,
it's a death room!
Guys, chill out, it's like an escape room.
We are going to chill out, significantly!
We'll talk about this later.
It's not this door. This door isn't it.
We gotta figure out how we're gonna. Whoa, I can feel it getting colder already. Look it. I've got goosebumps on my
arms.
Oh, okay, Professor Todd.
Tell me.
The Oompa Loompas are now lowering a candy sword, but only one. Good luck.
No, no. You wouldn't dare kill us.
Oh, cool. No, she's really mad at you.
No, I like her.
Yeah.
She's really mad at you. You made
no,
her
no, no,
for
no,
knowing
wait.
What time it was.
Yeah.
Well, okay, just chill out. Just chill out for just one second.
Quit saying chill out. The irony is not making sense.
I'm 14. It's my lingo. Listen, I just like, okay.
Let's tell the 14-year-olds say they say slay.
They say slay.
They say slay.
We say slay. We're all 14. We say slay.
Right, that's what I'm telling you. That's
See,
not what we say.
She doesn't even know what we say. You should stab her with this candy sword.
This is Willy Wonka. Can I hear one of you using the popular terminology from the drag queen community slay? Oh my god, are you RDR fans? Yes.
I've got no friends at school. Can you? I want them now.
Fine. Here's, you know what? Here, take it. It's $1 billion. Take it.
But I want friends that like me. Money means nothing.
If you give those kids money, they'll be your friends. That's how I made all my friends. Back before the war. Back before.
Daddy, stop talking about the war. No one cares, Daddy.
You know, I lost a lot of good friends, a lot of good Oompa Loompa friends in the Candy War. And it was so freaking sad.
This is the moment from the cinematic universe that won an Oscar. This award-winning monologue about the Candy Wars wins this man the Best Actor Award.
That is so scary. Summer of 1998, and I was listening to that Kid Rock song, however it goes. And I was having the best freaking summer of my life. I got my first kiss. I turned 18. I stole somebody's wallet. They couldn't find the guy for a while. They thought I was that guy because I had his wallet, but I wasn't that guy. And then the war happened. That's right. All the candy canes were pissed because we were chopping down the other candy canes. To harvest them. Sorry, guys, I'm shit-faced drunk right now. All the candy canes were so mad that we chopped down the candy cane forest that they rebelled. They became sentient. They grew little candy cane arms, and they started stabbing the Oompa Loompas. And the Oompa Loompas were having it. Me and the other Oompa Loompas, we got like actual guns. And so we started shooting all the candy canes, and then they would splinter apart, and all the splinters would start hurting the other Oompa Loompas. And then I was the only one left. And then I sold a bunch of candy canes. Oh, thanks. Sorry. And then I sold all the candy canes and made $1 billion. I hate you. You're my least favorite kid. You should have stayed at boarding school. Okay, I'm not. Look at my arms. I'm not that strong. It's gonna be funny.
Finish this story.
Okay, and then after we freaking mowed down all those candy canes with our real machine guns, my love, she was at the end of the forest, and she was so freaking disappointed in me. She didn't know I was a killer, and honestly, I didn't know I was a killer either. And that's so freaking sad. Is that good?
Boy, oh boy, life on a glass elevator, am I right?
Tell me about it.
Hey, buddy,
yeah.
There's no one I'd
468.
This is a private.
Just, I'm going to floor 68.
Yeah, fine.
Do we not look busy?
Hey, that's, you know, 68's one off, you know what I mean?
No, what do you mean?
Yeah, can you explain that?
Yeah, spell it out to us.
Hit the button. Hit the
I did.
No, we'd like you to explain that.
Okay, well.
67, right? Is that your lucky, your lucky number?
Yeah.
Wow.
Big 67 guy?
You guys don't like workplace humor, huh? You guys don't like.
We don't work here. Charlie owns this factory now.
Yes, I own this factory, and we come here for pleasure.
And I'm Charlie's forever bro.
Forever bro.
What are you, the janitor?
Yeah. So you work for me?
Yeah, hey, nice to meet you. My name is Don Quixote.
We can't wait.
That's a beautiful. Is that Spanish?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm doing this new diversity thing.
You don't see a lot of European and Spaniards working in the American factory force.
That's true, yeah.
I was born there.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was so off.
Why did you think I was born here?
It's because you got a Spanish name. I assumed you were natively Spanish. I'm sorry.
No.
You married into a Spanish family.
No. What the hell, man?
How do you think last names get got?
I was adopted. I was part of the system, dude. And then I got out. And now I'm a janitor. Yeah. Just in this class elevator.
Well, that's what the conquistadors get, you know?
Listen, you offended me. And I'm gonna report you. You're not gonna believe what this guy just said. He said I was European.
You look European.
Well, name one thing about me that makes me look European.
Yeah.
I'd like you to try.
Your webbed hands. Yeah, you must.
The fact that your ears come out here instead of here.
Yep.
I do have webbed hands.
Are you from the Levant?
Yeah, that's where I went to clown school. It was Levant, Paris.
Oh, a clowning man.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's why I'm a
clown. I'm sorry, brother. We didn't know you were a clown.
Yeah, I didn't know you were an artist.
We're not clowns. Yeah, I'm an artist.
Yeah, could you show us some of your best stuff?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Nice.
Oh my god, look, there was a live grenade in your ear! Oh my god, that's crazy! It's a live grenade!
Wait.
6 seconds left!
Is this some of your famous Levant humor?
It's a real grenade!
What are you doing to the real grenade?!
If I let go of the pin, we're all toast!
Hey, Charlie, do something!
Well,
no, that's the wrong thing to do!
I wish we were dead, but we're not. We must suffer through a bit more. We're closer.
Look at them.
We're closer. I'm looking at you. It is your prerogative to get back to New York.
They don't know what's going to happen. They don't know what's
going
to happen.
Okay. There's going to be a short break as I recalibrate the portals. And when we return, who knows? But take 10 minutes. Go get a drink. Go to the restroom till we get back. We'll have some more improv magic for you. Intermission!
Whoa!
trying to get us back into your realm, but things have gone awry. Somebody tried to jam raspberries into the blueberry gum. It's a mess. It's an absolute nightmare. So before I have our portal players try to navigate us back into your world, we've got a special treat. From the multiverse's wide, there are a large amount of amazing improv troops, but we have found the greatest of them all to hold you over. From your world, as a matter of fact, please welcome to the stage Teeny Tiny Women!
Prosper, huh? Maybe it's time we let bygones be bygones.
Yes.
think it's a problem. And they like ask for your soul for when you die, but there's all kinds of, there's like revivification, there's like all kinds of things you can do to get around that, so it's like not even a big deal. So, I'm gonna sell my soul. You don't have to sell your
Next.
Soul. I guess we did it. Are you happy, Howard? I've got little devil horns now. I'm a little cat, and I've got the ears with the devil horns next to them. You know how confusing that is. And what, so I can change the basic building structure of the universe at a whim? I'm Irish Catholic.
Scene.
Done it then?
Yes, right.
You've done it then?
Yes, right.
Take care of it.
Okay. Take care of things you need to.
I'm a man of my word. Come over here. Let me give you scratches.
All right. So she stowed away then?
That's right.
She stowed away?
That's right.
All right. And my wife's not gonna find her?
No.
Nope.
No, 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 no. She's in there nice and tight.
Okay.
Your wife's not gonna know.
Okay.
And her birthday surprise will not be ruined.
Okay. and that is why I trust you, and that is why you are the only head that I will scratch. Now this birthday, let me tell you,
yeah.
214 doesn't come around every year.
No, it's very, that's what, the silver anniversary? Wood?
What?
We know how it's...
We've got task lists on task lists. We've got cakes to bake and maids to order around and people to resurrect from her past. Come on.
That's true. That's true. What are unicorns like? I mean, we got the lady in the cake who's hiding under her bedroom. But what, I don't know, you have like a tennis bracelet or something?
I hadn't thought about it. I don't know. She's not much into jewelry. She really likes souls.
Souls?
Yeah.
Whoa!
Is the family of demons, correct?
Oh, yeah, yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
all right,
yeah,
all right.
No,
I just had to make sure.
Yeah, sorry, did a lot of drugs last night.
We all did.
Just getting it all back
we
in the old gold piece.
I was there, you don't remember.
Hey,
no
so listen.
Thing.
Hey, so listen.
Hey.
I was thinking maybe, I get my soul back?
I got a wife, I got my
have recalibrated. We're prepared. We're prepared to navigate us back through the portal places. I'm gonna need all my portal players back on stage. We've done it. We've successfully escaped from the Willy Wonka realm 879, where I was from the worst portal I've ever experienced. And I pray that God will never have another portal as dark and evil as that one. I need your help.
Do you want to sit down for a second?
I want to sit down every second of my life, but there's no time! There's no time.
You guys.
Comes reality.
Your blueberries.
And so I want to create new worlds. Wonderful new worlds. And I want all of your help. I want to know your favorite fandom. Please. Yes. Yes.
LJ.
Players, do you think that we could create some new Star Trek universes? It's a long story! Pray you don't know the horrors I know! So we're going to create some new movies! Some great new Star Trek movies, and it was LJ?
Yes.
LJ. And I'd like these movies to start with the letters LJ. Pitch me new movies, and if I think they are so worthy, I'd like to hear a little bit more. And if I'd like the full synopsis, I'd like to make it into the scene. Players, Star Trek. L-T. J-L-J. It's been a long day. All right, and begin.
Okay, picture it. Luke, comma, Jean.
Okay, let's hear it.
Jean-Luc Picard, captain of the Enterprise, wakes up and he's in the Terran Kingdom.
No.
Okay, Star Trek, Lyndon Johnson. They bring Lyndon B. Johnson back and he is mad.
Yeah, let's see.
And Lyndon B.
Ah, how much? Doesn't matter. I can do whatever I want. I'm dead. All right. Okay. Let's hear some more Star Trek movies. LJ, go.
Star Trek Little Jumpers.
Okay, let's hear more.
Okay, it's the kiddie version of the exact same Enterprise. They just did it with kids to make it more child friendly.
Kiddie, like kids? Let's see.
Sorry, but imagine it's as big as a T-Rex.
Oi!
What would you do to that Sheila right there?
Oh, I did. Bang!
Bang!
Hey, that's the movie! All right, yeah, Jurassic Park TV!
Dawn of Predators. Jurassic Park, Dawn of Predators. All right, let's see. It's all the scary dinosaurs fighting out there scary, and they just thought they were friends.
Yeah! Let's see that.
Yes. I'm a man. bad guy.
So they must speak for each other. Now, can I get a science fiction location this scene might take place?
Center of the Earth.
Center of the Earth. About as hot as I am right now. Let's see this scene. Players, are you ready?
Ready.
Begin.
Just a few more small adjustments to the mantle, and our probe will be ready to launch. Yeah, that just about does it. What a beauty, eh, Doctor?
Holy shit! Yeah! Everything's gone down, mantle, I'm insane!
I've been waiting for this moment for 10 years. I can't believe the government finally funded us. Gee, I wonder what is underneath this layer of the Earth's core.
Don't do it! Don't do it! I don't start you wondering and wondering and wishing and wondering. I wondered and wished all the way down here and now. I don't know what to do.
Doctor, I'm a professional, okay? And if man was not meant to explore the unknown, then why would we port upon this earth?
Buzz, are you fighting again? No fighting down here.
Mole Mother, I love you.
Oh, sweetheart, your grub is ready. Your mealworms are right here.
Look,
Mom,
I literally so fed up with how you treat her like she's the best kid here. I'm also your kid. Just because I was born 2 minutes after her doesn't mean she's the best.
Well, she's still my favorite.
You two, stop fighting so much and driving me crazy. Look, we are a bunch of researchers who happen to be mole people, funded by the U.S. government, and once we finally find out what's under this mantle, they'll finally acknowledge us and we will have our day in the sun. We don't need this petty bickering.
And they'll let us out, right? They'll let us see the rest of our mole people. We won't have to stay down here if we figure it out, right? Mmm, yummy, delicious.
Why are you asking me? You think that I have all the answers? You think that I've had to carry the weight of this whole family home by myself as the youngest kid, giving all responsibility? And you think that I have the answers? Or do I have my wits end?
Hey, maybe you should freaking chill out a little bit. How's that? Maybe you should stop jumping around like a little goofball.
Chill out? We're in the middle of the fucking earth! You think I can chill out? Everything's getting hotter by the moment!
Don't you dare get this close to my face.
One closer! You say don't get close, I'll get closer!
Look how tiny your arms are. You think your little mole arms can hurt me?
You know I'm insecure about my mole arms.
Mom, brother, can we put down our swords and batter them into plowshares?
I will not put down my swords until he admits that he's got teeny tiny little baby mole arms.
Good freaking God! I am about to murder you, mother!
I'd like to see you try. I bet your arms couldn't even reach me if I put my hand on top of your head.
No, you two, not the karate duel to the death.
That's right. It was in the mole prophecy. And I'm gonna kick his little mole ass.
Hi-ya! 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 Oh, my arms are so small!
Yes! Oh, we are navigating the portals ever so well, but we will need to do a few more experiments before I deem us free from the hellhole of Candyland. Alright.
I keep thinking those are your arms gonna come up, but it's just lumpy. It's so lumpy.
Get 2 chairs on the stage right now. And get Ilsa and Abby out here. I don't want any more of your back talk. For this next experiment, we're gonna have a lot of fun in the most delightful of universes yet. Can I get a suggestion of your favorite cartoon universe? Muppets.
Muppets. What is your name?
Lucy.
Would you like to join us on stage? No, that's completely fine. We're allowed to get two audience volunteers to just say a couple quick words. Yes, please. Yes.
Yay!
And one more person. Very simple. You're not going to have to act. You're just going to have to fill in the blank like a mad lib. Yes. Sorry, one more time. What was the universe?
Muppets.
Muppets, yes, Muppets. During this scene, our players are going to forget what to say, or they might even need help with a line. So they might come and gesture towards you so you can finish that line for them. It might look a little something like this.
Yes, for breakfast, I had some, like, Greek yogurt and some blueberries and...
Cow.
And a cold cow! And I just, like...
Or it might look something like this, Abby.
No, I'm not really in the mood for pizza. I'm hungry for something else, something greasy, like
pig. Yeah, pig! All right, players, you are in the Muppets universe. Are we ready? Begin!
My butt hurts.
I'm sorry, friend. It's hard being the designated human in the Muppet universe. I don't have that problem.
Oh, yeah, that's true. but your butt doesn't hurt because you have a thing up there.
Really?
Yeah. I didn't want to be the one to tell you, but what it is it's a...
A hand.
It's a hand, like this.
Where?
Well, it is...
Gosh, that makes me feel special, Abby Kadabby. Thank you for sharing that with me. I want to share something with you now. I actually have a confession to make. I've been harboring it for years, but I...
I'm divorced.
A Muppet who's divorced?
Kermit and Miss Piggy weren't always together.
Oh.
What? Yeah. Are you saying what you were with Kermit?
I was with Miss Piggy.
But she's so much hotter than you.
She's a lot to handle sometimes. I don't know. Actually, we'd spend all this time on the beach, and she'd talk about her hopes and dreams, and I'd talk about...
Her hopes and dreams.
Yeah, you were giving desperate.
It was stifling. It was stifling, but I'm much happier now that I'm with an animal.
You're with an animal?
His name's Animal.
Oh! Yeah, I know that guy. He's the one with the...
The hair.
The hair! That is...
Rough.
The rough hair! Oh, that animal!
Yeah.
A wooga!
I know, but the way he plays the drums is just so sporadic. Sometimes it reminds me of...
Silence.
And utter silence.
That's so beautiful. I wish I could find a love like that. But, I mean, I'm the only human amongst a whole bunch of Muppets, so it'd be kind of weird.
I don't know. I think you could find someone like Amy Adams or something.
That's true. Amy Adams. She's the one that looks like Isla Fisher, but more
but it's
boring.
Different.
Yeah. Got it. I remember. Yeah, she's... Fine.
Yeah, well, I think you guys would be compatible because she's so eager to help people and you're so...
Eager to please.
Yes, I am. And you know what? The last time I pleased a Muppet was just last week. And you know what I did for them?
I'm nervous to ask.
I blew Snuffle up against his trunk. Yeah.
I haven't even really explained explain things all that well. So for this next scene, I would like to give us an opportunity to field questions, to answer some questions of our own that we have standing. So if all of our players could disperse, I'd like to single a few out and see if we can ask these people some hard-hitting questions from one of their favorite universes. Can I get a science fiction world or universe that you love? Like Star Trek or Stargate or Star Wars.
Hitchhiker's Guide.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. What is a problem that would necessitate a town hall situation from the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy?
Lack of towels.
Lack of towels! All right, we're here at a town hall to discuss the recent lack of towels in the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy universe. Please, would you introduce yourself?
Thank you, Blueberry. Hello, I am the Hitchhiker from the galaxy, and this is my wife, the Hitchhikeress, and we're here to talk about the towels. So I'll take anybody's question.
Excuse me, I'd like to say.
Oh, sorry. Really set myself up for
that. First of all, love you as my fans, and I know we see each other around. Second of all, the top hit of the radio this month is about damn time by Lizzo. Alright, we have questions about Tom.
You there, the loud one. Go
question
ahead.
Hi. Staff on Beagle Bronx, president of our respect. Two head guy.
Say that one more time.
Staff on Beagle Bronx, president of our space.
Do you have like golf balls in your mouth? What's going on?
I have two heads. Hey man, I got two heads, alright? I kind of got two personalities in the movie. Now look, I think this towel deficit is vastly overblown. I believe it's an internet conspiracy meant to make my administration look weak. So let's just sweep towels under the rug and focus on the important things, like building space highways. Is that okay, Will?
I don't like how it does that.
A huge fan of the Hitchhikers, by the way. Oh, love your work.
Thank you so much. Yeah, we do a lot of it. Okay. Yeah, we after we do this town hall, we can move on to a new thing. But right now, we are going to stay focused on the towels, not the space highways. Does anybody else have a question?
As I was saying, I appreciate your concern, but we are keeping towels as of now.
I'm Janice. I'm the former ex of Two Head, and I'm just curious. Are there going to be washcloths? Are there going to be beach towels? Are we completely out for the count?
I'm glad you asked. I'm so sorry for your loss.
Don't bring it up. Why'd you bring it up? Why would you bring it up?
I feel like I'm playing at a loss here. We're working on getting more towels, okay? We're going to find more towels, but...
Well, what about the washcloth? And what about the beach towels?
Right now we are sticking just with bathroom towels. Beach is for pleasure, and until our highways are fixed, we can only focus on hygiene.
Yeah, okay. We're not worried about the pattern towels that are thinner for some reason. We're worried about the thicker ones that you get from Target.
When we get the beach towels that are for pleasure, that one can't have any of them.
Oh, what would you know about pleasure?
Oh, you
space laundry, okay? Just relax.
We have a restraining order.
And I have a question over here. I have a question over here.
Hi.
Hi.
I am Leapworm from the Ewoks. I've never seen this movie. I was just wondering, we're pretty furry, and we really need the towels because when it rains, it gets really wet, and then I can't dry, and I get real cold.
And you have to dry off.
Oh, I get dry off.
We have to get towels for that.
We've got to get towels for that.
What'd you say your name was?
Lady.
Do you want to be the new president of space?
Yeah.
Hey, listen up! That was a comedy! Sit down!
Let's see! I have all of our questions answered. And I dare say, you've narrowly avoided the horror show that is my reality. And we've traversed
successfully back to New York.
What? What?
No. Wait, no!
They're going to Chicago. They're going to Chicago.
Hot dog.
We have to go further.
I did some recalibration, and we're back in Chicago.
We made it!
Yay!
Oh, it's been a long and arduous journey, and I thank you all for joining us tonight. My name is Blueberry, but I also go by Nick.
I'm Ilsa.
Brandon.
Grace. Abby. Mark.
Thank you so much for joining us in this crazy, hectic show tonight. We do this every week. We do a different journey in a different world.
You have to do the voice the whole time. So you
have to do the voice this whole time. And so, I'm exhausted. I'm going to get out of this sweaty.
Whoa!
If you want to see a bunch of really fun multiverses, keep in touch with our socials. We do a lot of fun multiverses. Sometimes it's Star Trek. Sometimes next week is Pokemon. Come back if you're a huge Pokemon fan. And, good night!
Otherworld, you gotta love the world. Otherworld, yeah. Otherworld, yeah. Otherworld.